you study Pika Pika, it's really interesting to notice that, you know, Kobayashi's arrangement brought about the inside notes, right? So you're actually moving quite a bit. Many people actually like to keep 1 and 3 kind of steady there on the 5th string, 11th fret, on the 9th fret, on the 4th string. And you're actually dancing with your pinky and your middle finger on the 1st string. Open. 6, 5th. Right? For me, sometimes it's easier to actually just make them land when they're needed. If you notice, there's a little bit movement of the arm, of the elbow, as I do that. For the video, I'm exaggerating that movement. Then you actually have them together, right? So you are on the 10th fret here for that C, and then you have an E over here, the 9th fret on the 3rd string. So A bass now. And forgive the tuning of my strings, they're very, very old right now. Then you're using 3 and 2 for this one. There's no easy way. You actually have to just be dancing between that G sharp and that D, right? 6th fret, 7th fret, 1 takes care of it. This one is quite easy. Easier to make a bar, but you have to have that open E string, right? So your index finger has to dance around.